Welcome back to Face the Nation. We're discussing the question. The Supreme Court has said that the government must quickly dispose of all mercy petitions because it is a living hell for those who are on death row and who still don't know what's going to happen to their mercy petitions. Is it time to end capital punishment? Then we're asking if the government simply cannot decide whether it should hang or should not. Harsh Mandar, let me get you to respond to what Mahesh Jethmalani was saying, which is that what if Ajmal Kasab, whose trial is going on now, again goes from appeal to appeal and goes from court to court and ends in a mercy petition. Then is there not an argument to say that for terrorist crimes, for such heinous crimes, for attacking parliament, for attacking people in Mumbai, for plots to assassinate heads of state, there should be death penalty in a country like India?
I mean, I profoundly disagree. But, you know, firstly, you know, what is terrorism and, you know, mass violence, for instance? You've had the carnage in Gujarat, for instance. You've had Bhagalpur. You've had the Sikh riots. How is it, you know, how is one crime more heinous than the other?
That's a good point.
So I think that I think that all crimes, you know, where politics has been used, need to be dealt with in the same way. Second, you know, it's one step away to justify capital punishment because you cannot use normal systems of law. But, and then you justify encounter killings, torture, and so on and so forth. But the most important thing, I think, really is that history has shown that terrorism is never crushed by the brute force of the state. Terrorism is fostered on a sense of injustice, and it is that injustice that has to be, that sense of injustice that has to be addressed, and the support for terrorism will evaporate. And in that, and it's only a humane, civilized society bound by the rule of law that is the most effective in controlling
Mahesh Jethmalani, how do you decide what is a heinous crime is the question. What about the burning of Graham Staines? Is that not a heinous crime? The Supreme Court gave death sentence to Afzal Guru saying because of the collective conscience of the nation demands, therefore he must be awarded death sentence even though the evidence is circumstantial, even though there is no evidence he's part of any band organized. So how do you decide which is a heinous crime and which deserves a death sentence?
Surely it's not for you, me, Mr. Mandar or Mr. Singhvi to decide this question. The fact of the matter is, Parliament in its wisdom has already decided which offences will attract the death penalty and which will not attract the death penalty. Now, if anybody has a grievance, you should be taking it to Parliament. So as long as these offences attract the death penalty, it should be imposed. Now, you know, Mr. Mandar says that history has shown us. I don't think, in fact, in India, the experience is quite the contrary, and Mr. Mandar should realize that. We have never sentenced any terrorist to, given a death sentence to any terrorist since Kehar Singh assassinated Mrs. Gandhi, if Kehar Singh could be called a terrorist. Nobody has been given. And because of that, terrorism in this country has proliferated. There's been no deterrent aspect. So I don't know what historical experience he's been living through. I have a contrary. In Bombay alone, we've had 21 terrorist incidents and nobody has been given the death sentence.
Mr. Mandar, maybe terrorism would be less in India if we had the death penalty.
They may not have been the death penalty, but we've used encounter killings, we've used, abandoning the rule of law in relation to terrorists. And there has been the outrage is equally that there has nobody been punished yet for the 1984 carnage. And I think that, for instance, is the source of a huge amount of the kind of dissatisfaction that finally leads to people taking up arms. So I think that there is no shortcut to justice and rule of law being followed impartially.
Okay, so the death penalty only breeds a violent state. But Abhishek Manu Singhvi, now how long is the Afzal Guru case going to wake? It's a political metaphor. It clearly shows that the government knows this is a political hot potato. It can't act on the Afzal Guru case. Therefore, it's just buying time as a tactical device to keep it going. Meanwhile, the Supreme Court has made a stinging denunciation of you, saying you're using these people as pawns and political chattel, and that's exactly what you're doing.